Workshop participants practicing cutting stencils and using spray paint to see the result of their work for the mural to be painted on Roxburgh's former magnet tea rooms. The workshops have been popular with both residents and visitors who travelled from Christchurch, Invercargill and Southland to participate in the art project.
It's about learning how to hold the knife even and making sure that they're cutting into the stencil, the cut mat. So there's little technical things like that. And then really just, I mean, it's a difficult thing to teach, like anything kind of artistic. It's like you just got to have a go, you know.
Street artist Hayley King, known as Phlox, has asked those attending the workshops to come up with an image that explains what the Teviot Valley means to them. Some of the ideas submitted include architecture, fruit, and the many cultures who have come here.
Everyone sort of feels differently or has a different experience with the Teviot, so we did expect there to be quite a vast, you know, a variety of different images to come out of it.
This last weekend, King and fellow artist Ross Leal projected images on the side of the building to guide where the mural will be painted.
We've got our projector over there and we're projecting the wall in, I'm not sure how many times we're going to have to project, probably about 9 times. But yeah, just putting down some basic lines for some parts of the mural, all the sort of freehand parts.
She says the layout of the building's walls will have a big influence in how the mural will look.
There's like 6 windows, I think, on the main side. So we had to work our design to suit and make sure that there's nothing major being lost behind any of the windows. So it's not just a big blank canvas. We've got to work around some architectural elements as well.
The project is the brainchild of the Teviot Valley Community Development Scheme alongside the Central Otago District's Arts Trust. In Roxburgh, the South Today. This one I've already had in the ODT.